Cheevo, guys!
What up, guys? This is
Cheevo, guys!
Back here again with another achievement guide. Today, we're going to be focusing on Double Dragon in the Kunio-Kun Retro Brawler Bundle. This game was originally released on the Nintendo and the Famicom. It has been ported over in HD for the Xbox One, PS4, and Switch, along with 6 other games. They have 7 of them available in the USA, and then there's 11 of them that are exclusive to Japan. So there's actually 17 of these games that were just released by Arc System Works. These games are only $4.99, and you can get about 600 or 700 achievement points in just about 5 minutes. However, the last 3 achievements are going to take some time. Although, overall, I'd say it's going to take about 1 hour to 2 hours to get your full completion or platinum trophy. Luckily, we can save our game, which wasn't available back in the day, so we'll be able to use a strategy called save scumming. This is where you save a lot in effort to not lose any progress. So like, let's say you're facing a hard boss, you could hit them, save it, hit them, save it. That way you can get through it pretty easily. The main 2 benefits to doing this is to make sure that you do not lose any extra lives and that you do not lose any extra time. Okay, so first let's get the easy achievements knocked out. We wanna go to the settings and then we wanna go to individual settings. Go ahead and click any of these characters. This is going to unlock our first achievement. The achievements are going to pop up on the upper left-hand side of the screen. This one is worth 100 gamer score called Transform for changing your avatar. Next, we're going to go ahead and edit our background. Just go ahead and pick any background and press A. This is going to unlock another achievement for another 100 gamer score. This one is the Change Your Backgrounds achievement for changing your background. Pretty simple. Next, we want to go to Set Screen Mode. And then you can pick any mode you want. I like to pick full screen mode, but what we really need to do is go down to the scan lines and we need to adjust the scan lines. Just go ahead and change it to whatever you prefer. Personally, I changed it to smooth, and then make sure that you press A to confirm. This is going to unlock our next achievement. That's the CRT screen achievement for 100 gamer score for adjusting the scan lines. Next, you want to go down to the sound settings and you want to turn the reverb on. Go ahead and press A. That's going to unlock the Reverbation of Retro Sound achievement for turning on reverb in sound options. Another 100 gamer score. After that, we're going to get an achievement for setting up an online match. So go to online play. You want to go to create a room. And then this is going to help us unlock our next achievement. Settings don't matter. We're going to quit it right away. So just go ahead and create the room. Once it's created, your achievement should pop. That's going to be worth another 100 gamer score. That's called Show Us What You've Got. We're creating your own private match. Then you can go ahead and go to disband to go ahead and cancel that room. Press confirm. Alright, so now we can go ahead and work on the last achievements. These are going to be related to mode A and mode B. Let's go ahead and check out what we have so far. So far we have 500 of 1000. It's crazy how easy the developer made the first half of the gamer score on all these Kunio-Kun games. We do have another achievement for opening up the control panel. However, you do that in game. I'll show you that once we start up mode A. But for now, I want to explain mode B real quick. Mode B is pretty much a different type of game mode. It's pretty much a fighting game, so you just have to defeat your opponent and get their life bar all the way to 0. If you're having trouble going down on the menu, it's because you have to press X to go down, and then you press Y to select it. It's kind of confusing. Make sure you start up mode B, one player, and then you want to play it with each of these characters. It's only one match, so we have to do 6 matches total. So once you defeat one match, you're going to go to the next one. You have to do this without resetting the game. So once you defeat a character, it's automatically going to put you back to the main menu. So you're going to go to the next character. So make sure that you save your game when you start each match. You can save your game during mode B as well. That way you don't mess it up at all, because if you end up dying, you're going to have to restart it, because the achievement specifically says you have to do this in one run. So we're going to have to complete it with all 6 characters. This doesn't take too long. Especially because we're taking advantage of the save mechanic. I recommend using RB to use your flying kick attack. Pretty much all these characters have a flying kick attack, except for the last character. With that character, you're pretty much going to have to spam the punch and the kick. Biggest tip and thing to note, though, is to make sure that you save it at the beginning of every match. Because, again, you have to do this without resetting it. So if you happen to die or you start the game over, you're going to have to get the achievement all over again, because you have to do all 6 in a row. Personally, I messed up and I hadn't completed all of them in a row, so I had to go back and complete it again with the first character. Once I did so, I had completed all 6 in one session without restarting the game, and my achievement popped for 100 gamer score. Now, personally, my achievement for completing all other achievements didn't unlock. Of course not. I kind of freaked out at first, but if you go ahead and you quit your game and you restart it, the achievement should pop once the game starts up again. I just started up the game and it popped right away. That's the last achievement for completing all achievements. I just want to throw that out real quick before I dive into the full walkthrough, because that is going to be the lengthier portion of this video. So at this point, all we have to do is start up the game on mode A. We need to open up the control manuals and then simply complete the game. It's going to be easier because we can use the save scum method. Just make sure that you save your game often, that way you aren't losing any time. I also want to note, each level has a time limit, guys. You can see it at the bottom center of the screen. You need to make sure that you complete the level before this time limit. Now real quick, let's go ahead and pop up the pause menu. We're going to go over to control manual. And then this is going to pop our next achievement. You just need to make sure that you access all pages of the control manual. So go all the way over to the right. I think there's 3 pages total. That's going to unlock the Master of Controls achievement for 100 gamer score. At this point, we have 800 of the 1000 gamer score. We just have 2 achievements left. One for completing the game on mode A, and then the other for completing all other achievements. Now the game has 4 missions. You're going to see me complete it in just about 24 minutes here in the rest of the video. At first, I wasn't going to upload a full walkthrough through the game. I was under the impression that it was pretty straightforward. You know, most of the side-scrolling games, you just walk over to the right, defeat all of the enemies. It's pretty self-explanatory. However, this completion ended up taking me about 4 or 5 hours because I didn't know what I was getting myself into. So I want to give you guys some tips and tricks, that way you guys don't waste any time. So first and foremost, make sure that you save your game. You can save your game by pausing it and going over to suspend save. Just choose one of the 4 slots and you're good to go. I'd recommend saving it after you kill a few enemies. So, you know, every time you kill 4 or 5 enemies, I recommend saving it. Now in the bottom center of the screen, you can find 2 main things that we're going to be looking at. One is the time limit, and then the other is the amount of lives that we have. So above that, it says P-2. That means that we have 2 lives. We are going to have to complete the game with only 2 lives, and we also need to complete each of the levels in under the time limit. Personally, I ended up getting all the way to the last level, and apparently I spent too long on the last level because I had no way to complete it in under the time limit with the saves that I was working with. Even when I ran through it quickly, I only had less than 20 seconds left in the last level. So make sure that you save your game. On the last level, you do not have very much time to complete it. Also, sometimes your enemies will drop weapons. You can pick them up with the B button, and you can use them with the B button. The weapons are really effective, so anytime that an enemy drops one, I recommend picking it up and using it. Now, for the most part, you do have to defeat all of the enemies before you can proceed through these levels. However, there are a few parts in the game where you do not have to do this, and you can skip a bunch of enemies. So make sure that you follow along with the video in an effort to skip those enemies and to complete this game as quickly as possible. Now at first, you aren't going to have the flying kick. This is because you need to upgrade your character before you learn the extra moves. If you press start and you go to the control manual, it'll show you all of the different moves and what level you need to be to execute that move. The level that you're at is represented by the hearts below your HP meter. So right now we're on level 2. I'm going to be showing you guys a trick at the beginning of mission 2 to be able to upgrade quickly. That way you have all of the different attacks at the beginning of the game. However, in the first mission, we're going to have to defeat all of the enemies with no upgraded moves. Personally, I recommend using A to kick. I found that the kick was the most effective attack on enemies, maybe just because it has the most range. Once you defeat that first little boss, that's going to push us into mission 2. So as I mentioned before, there is going to be a little glitch at the beginning of this level to be able to upgrade quickly. That way we can use all of the moves like the flying kick. So just make sure that you defeat these enemies in the beginning. As you proceed, some enemies will start throwing stuff at you, like projectile attacks. And just simply, you know, walk in front of them and then they're going to throw it and then just move up or down. So that way you're not parallel with them and you don't get hit by whatever they're throwing. So you're going to have to defeat these first few guys in the beginning of this level. Dodge the guy with the box, and then after you defeat them, it's going to say head over to the right hand side. We're going to have to defeat this last guy, and then I'm going to show you guys the trick right here. You can try to kick him off like that, and then we can climb up these cages. So I'm going to go ahead and save the game here just because this is right before the glitch and I want to make sure that I do it correctly. So save your game and then climb up the cage. We're going to walk over to the right. You can fly kick that guy. You should have the flying kick by now. You get it once you get to level 3. As you can see, I have 3 hearts on the bottom side of the screen. Gonna fall off that cage there. I don't recommend climbing down. Every time I climbed down it, I fell down that pit. Alright guys, so this is all about timing. So the enemies are gonna start walking over. You want to start climbing up the cage right when the guys get right there. You start climbing the cage, it freezes the enemies. So once he's frozen right in front of those pillars, we're gonna go all the way back and we're gonna fall off or climb down the cage. And then we're gonna go back and we're gonna see that the enemies have disappeared. Now we're gonna go where that enemy was and we're gonna start swinging, and we're going to see that we're going to start getting points on the lower left hand side of the screen. So basically the game thinks that the enemy is still there, but he's not. I'm gonna go ahead and fast forward this a bit, but you're gonna hit it a couple times, probably just swing the bat for like a minute, and you're going to give yourself all of the upgrades. Just keep swinging it until you have all 7 hearts. At that point, you can go over to the control manual and you'll be able to execute all of these different moves, making it a lot easier to defeat enemies quickly. Other than that, guys, that about covers all of my tips and tricks for this walkthrough. I personally recommend watching the video so you know exactly where to go, so you aren't wasting any time. I went ahead and edited out all of my deaths for you guys, so that way it's straight to the point and I'm not saving a bunch. Also, this game has a loop mechanic, guys, so after you defeat the bosses, make sure that you go into the doors that they came from. Because if you don't, you're just gonna loop the level over and over again. And this is why I spent so much time on my completion, is because I thought, damn, this level is long as hell, but I was just looping it over and over again. So after you defeat the boss, make sure that you walk through the door that they came from. Also, make sure to give yourself some good save checkpoints on the last level, because you do have to complete that level pretty quickly. Other than that, guys, as always, I appreciate you guys tuning in. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a comment and don't forget to like and subscribe.
Thank you.
Other than that, guys, as always, I appreciate you guys tuning in. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a comment and don't forget to like and subscribe.